I'm Rob with Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you how to do a quick static check on this Magnetek Impulse G+ and VG+ Series 3 of crane inverters. Now, the first thing that we're going to do is turn the machine off and make sure that the drive has been powered down for some time, because we want that DC bus to discharge. If we're doing this check in the machine, we're also going to want to make sure we disconnect all the inputs and outputs. That way we get a clear reading. Now, after the drive has been sitting for some time, you'll want to go ahead and verify that the DC bus has been discharged. On this specific inverter, there is a charge LED here that should go out when the DC bus has been completely discharged. But we're going to go ahead and verify that. That way we don't get any accidental shock. You're going to take the negative probe and put it on the negative side of the DC bus, and the positive probe and put it on the positive side of the DC bus, and take a measurement. So
negative to negative, positive to positive. And it looks like we're showing about 0.04 volts.
Now that's great, and I wouldn't proceed any farther if it was any more than 1 volt. I would just give the DC bus a little bit more time to discharge. So the next test that we're going to perform is a phase to ground check on both the inputs and the outputs. We're going to go ahead and set our digital multimeter to the continuity setting. We're going to take the negative probe and find a good ground, and then we're going to take the positive probe and go between R, S, and T, and U, V, and W.
This will be a great ground. We'll go between R, S, and T, and then go U, V, and W.
Well, that's great. None of our phases are to ground, so we'll go ahead and move on to our next test, is checking the inputs and outputs of the transistor modules using our diode check function. Now, what we're going to be doing is taking the negative probe and putting it on the positive side of the DC bus, and taking the positive probe and going between R, S, and T, and then take a reading.
Negative probe, positive DC bus. Between R, 0.45, S, 0.45, and T, 0.46.
So that's great. The readings should be anywhere between 0.2 and 1 volt, but most importantly, they're balanced across all three phases. So now we're going to check the other side, and then we'll take the positive probe and place it on the negative side of the DC bus, and then we'll take our negative probe and go between R, S, and T.
Positive probe, negative DC bus, and go R, 0.46, S, 0.45, and T, 0.46.
That's great, they're checked fine. Now we're going to go ahead and check the outputs the exact same way.
Negative probe, positive DC bus, between U, 0.44, V, 0.44, and W,
0.44. Okay, that's great. Let's go ahead and switch our leads.
Positive probe, negative side of the DC bus, U, 0.43, V, 0.43, and W, 0.43.
So that's great. Both the inputs and outputs are checking just fine. So if you need any more help with troubleshooting, please contact us at precisionzone.com. We'd be more than happy to help you figure out what's going on with your machine. Thanks for watching.